Welcome back to 10 Slide Info's Defense Update Series. In today's video, we'll see three updates on the defense side. The first one is regarding India showing interest to buy the drone which was used to kill the Iranian major. The second update is regarding Airbus helicopters offering the H225M to Indian Coast Guard. The third one is regarding the export of T-7A Red Hawk trainer aircraft which is developed by Boeing and SAAB. So let's see each topic one by one in a detailed manner. On January 3, 2020, the Iranian Major General Qasem Soleimani of Islamic Revolutionary Guards Corps was assassinated using a drone strike by the US troops near the Baghdad International Airport. As this was done in a very secure and secret manner, the Indian Defense are showing interest to acquire such technology in their fleet, as the drone quietly sneaked in and launched its missile accurately to hit the target. Several terrorists who performed dangerous terrorist attacks in India, like the November 26 attack in Mumbai and February 14 Pulwama attacks, are hiding in Pakistan and are being given protection by some unknown sources. Both Jaish-e-Mohammad Chief Masood Azhar and Lashkar Chief Hafiz Saeed have been roaming openly in Pakistan, continuing their activities against India. So such drones might be very useful to carry similar operation in a silent and secure way, and India might be bringing this in discussion during United States President Trump's two-day visit to India during February 24 and February 25. Now coming to the second update on the defense side is the Airbus offerings for the Indian Coast Guard. Airbus is very keen on winning the military choppers order from India and is lining up a series of helicopters for each open tender. There are two major orders which are kept open, which is the requirement of 111 naval utility helicopter and 123 naval multi-role helicopters. In addition to this, the United States has already approved the sale of 24 multi-role MH-60R Seahawk helicopters to India at an estimated cost of $2.6 billion. As a quick deal, Airbus is offering its H225M for the 14-unit requirement from the Indian Coast Guard for search and rescue operations. And in this, even the Sikorsky S-92 might also be competing, but nothing is confirmed as of now. The Airbus H225M is a twin-engine, long-range tactical transport military helicopter which can carry up to 28 seated troops along with two crew members, and this helicopter is marketed for troop transport, casualty evacuation and combat search and rescue duties. So we need to see if India is interested to buy this particular variant from Airbus helicopters. Now coming to the third update of Boeing and Saab's T-7A Red Hawk. Boeing has announced an intention to export the T-7A Red Hawk trainer aircraft to the countries of Asia-Pacific region, and they will share the marketing responsibility with the production partner Saab. And this announcement was made in the Singapore Air Show 2020, in which Boeing mentioned that it is positioning the T-7A Red Hawk for the military trainer and light attack requirements across the Asia-Pacific region, which it is developing and building along with Sweden's Saab. Boeing in September 2018 won a $9.2 billion contract to provide 351 T-7A Red Hawk jets to United States Air Force. And this is along with the 46 simulation systems and associate ground equipments. And these deliveries has to be completed by 2034 as of now. The trainer aircraft which Boeing and Saab are offering are being acquired to replace the fleet of Northrop T-38C Talons that entered service in 1961. During the T-X competition, the US Air Force selected Boeing Saab's T-7A to become its trainer aircraft against the other competitors, which were Lockheed Martin and Leonardo DRS. So what is this T-X competition? The T-X competition is nothing but it's a program which United States Air Force Development has launched to acquire a new two-seat jet trainer to replace the Northrop T-38 Talons. Boeing is using a model-based engineering and design efforts along with virtual reality to design and to produce these aircrafts. Not only this, the use of digital engineering also strengthened the computational fluid dynamics-based model for these aircrafts. The Swedish Saab has commenced assembly production for this advanced jet trainer, and it is producing the 7 fuselage sections in Sweden, which will then undergo the final assembly at Boeing's factory in St. Louis, Missouri. This achievement is possible due to the great collaboration between Sweden's Saab and United States Boeing. The T-7A has generated interest from air forces worldwide, and Boeing expects the demand for these aircrafts not only as a trainer but as a light attack platform. And this aggressor aircraft can be used for training purpose as well, and also for light attack operations. So let's hope Boeing and Saab win many more contracts worldwide for this powerful and unique trainer aircrafts. Thanks for watching. So these were the three updates on the defense side which I thought I'll share in this particular video. Please do subscribe my channel and hit the bell button next to it, and also feel free to leave a comment in the comment section. Thank you.